Right, so what I want to look at today is a couple of myth-busting videos. So the first one I'm going to look at is cadence for runners. Cadence is something that came out from the 1984 Los Angeles Olympics. It was an observation of 800 meters all the way through to marathon, elite level runners. So what I want to try and discuss here is this something that you should be aiming for in your running, or is it something else that you need to look at first? So I'm going to show you a few different runs on the treadmill and then we'll have a little discussion about it.
So do some landmines. Shoulder press landmines. Is that heavy enough?
Okay, so what we've got there is two runners. And the first runner, you'll see very low heels, very quick, and this is what we commonly see happen when people try and get towards 180 as a cadence when they're running. They haven't really looked at the form. The second runner is running at the same pace, but he's spending a lot less time on the ground, on off ground quicker, better leg cycle, much more efficient and easier for the body, so better form. As that form is held, then we can start to build on the cadence through fitness. But you must have a good running technique in place first, because if your form is not there, what you're going to do is accentuate the problems that are already in your movement patterns. So you will tend to overstride more, you will tend to get your heels lower, and obviously that's going to cause a lot more loading for the tissues through your foot, your knee, your hips, and potentially your back as well. So I think we have to really sort of look at this and go, 180 is something to aim for if you're an elite athlete. But I would suggest what you really need to aim for if you're a recreational runner or even sort of an amateur club runner is look at getting your technique right first so you've got something to work with, then go back and look at your cadence following that and see where you start to shape up. But get that form right.